and how we can convert the normal street lights into smart street lights. So this is the city with smart street lights. Now let me introduce the smart street lighting. It has been a while since artificial light was allowed to see in the dark. So with the discovery of light, we can see even in the dark. We can now light the homes we live in, our work spaces, office spaces, of course the street we wander. So from going from home to office, we have to move on the streets, so we can illuminate these streets with the street lights. This invention has made our lives easier. So it is a part of science. The purpose of science is to make your life easier. Similarly, the street lights or the lighting system had made your life easier, because earlier when the light was not discovered, the working hours for the people were only in the day hours. In the night hours, they can't do any work, any commercial work, any official work, any domestic work. As public lighting has become norms in most parts of the world, so this public lighting system has become in most parts of the world. This public lighting system is there. The street lighting system is there. Street lighting is now a core piece of urban and rural infrastructure. So this. Whether it is a rural infrastructure or the urban infrastructure, the street light is a core main part of this infrastructure, urban and this rural infrastructure, creating a safe environment for pedestrian and the drivers alike. So the people who are walking on the pedestals and the people who are driving their vehicle on the roads, the street lights give the safe environment, reduce number of accidents, reduce number of theft and robbery will take place in the presence of street lights. Now the cost for municipalities. The municipalities in all the urban cities are responsible for managing the street lights in their cities. So what is the cost of street lights which the municipalities are maintaining? At local and municipal level, public authorities oversee providing street lighting as a key public service for citizen safety. So the role of municipality in any city is to provide street lights, maintain street lights for safety of the citizens. This, however, represents a major cost for the local government, which can be challenging to accommodate and sustain. So management of the street lights, their electricity bill, their erection, their maintenance, their operation is a major cost for any local municipality, and it is a challenging task, okay, to manage say 50,000, 1 lakh, 2 lakh street lights in a small town to big town. Moreover, it is still common for municipalities to use outdated and inefficient street lighting facilities. Still, in lot of cities over India, we use the outdated street lights, that is the high density mercury vapor lamps or sodium vapor lamps, which consume lot of power, and they are inefficient in the sense that these street lights, which are based on the technology of mercury vapor and sodium vapor lights, along with the light, they also emit heat energy, infrared energy. And infrared energy is doing nothing. It is causing a huge heat pollution, and no useful purpose is done. Second thing which is differentiating the normal street lights, that is the LED street lights, from the sodium vapor light, the color of the light is not suitable to our eyes. Means the visibility in the case of sodium vapor lights is not as good as LED lights. And another drawback of sodium vapor light is it causes the change of color. The color which we see in the sunlight will be different when we view any objects in the presence of sodium vapor lights. So it is not soothing to our eyes. We are not comfortable with sodium vapor lights. So which leads to a higher energy consumption. As I explained, that they also consume, dissipate the heat energy along with the light energy. Therefore, their power consumption is more. And increased maintenance cost. Frequently, these bulbs get fused, the ballast get damaged, the capacitor which is mounted in these ordinary street lights get damaged, or igniters get damaged. So the failure rate of the components which is used in sodium vapor light is very high, and they are frequent failures. And obsolete lighting system can account for as much as 50% of a typical city entire energy bill. So whatever is the energy bill of a city, the 50% will be used to pay the electricity charges to illuminate the street lightings. Now, if you see the total budget which is provided to the municipalities to manage the city, about 10 to 20% is utilized in paying the energy charges to utility companies, the distribution companies. And to 10 to 20% is the operation and maintenance cost. Operation and maintenance cost means daily in the evening you have to switch it on, daily in the morning you have to switch it off. So that operation and maintenance cost is also 10 to 20%. So you can see about 40% of the municipality budget is used to pay the energy bill for the street lights and to maintain the operation and maintenance of street lights. So this is a major chunk of expenditure which is occurring by the municipalities. Now, the another aspect which we learn about how this use of these inefficient street lighting can cause the environmental concern. The issue of large energy consumption is a concern not only at local level but also globally. So if you use more and more electricity to illuminate the street lights, then it is a global concern, because from where this electricity is coming, major chunk of this electricity is produced by the coal-fired or the gas-fired or the oil-fired power stations. Now, in the process of generating power by these fossil fuels, they emit the carbon dioxide and greenhouse gases like sulfur dioxide and nitrous oxide into the atmosphere. And these greenhouse gases, as you know, will raise the temperature of the surface of the earth. When the earth temperature goes high, the ice caps which is on the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere will start melting, and when they will start melting, the sea level will rise, and all the urban cities which are in the sea coastal area, they will get submerged. So it is a huge concern. Public lighting has been named the nervous system of a city. Say street lighting is a nervous system of a city. When the city light is out, the people feel discomfort, the people feel uncomfortable. Connecting hundreds of millions of the street light with access to power across the globe. So these street lights are connecting all the cities with the street lights. This constantly increasing number has made lighting responsible for a staggering 19% of the global electricity uses. So in order to illuminate the cities throughout the world or throughout the globe, about 19% of the electricity is used and is contributing towards the already exceeding level of CO2 emission. So when we generate the power, the CO2 is emitted in the different industrial applications like chemical plant, cement plant. These greenhouses are emitted, and if we use more and more street lights, more and more CO2 will be pumped into the atmosphere. Their temperature will rise. Given that, the according to UN, United Nations, 68% of the total world population will live in the urban areas by 2050. By looking into the trends, the migration of rural people, the people living in the village, to metro cities and urban cities, it is estimated the total population, say at this time it is about 7 billion. So out of this 7 billion, 68% will migrate towards the cities. And when they come into the city, naturally they will be, the size of the cities will increase and more street lights has to be provided for their inhabitants. It seems more imperative than ever to protect cities' limited resources. So cities already have got the limited resources in terms of the municipality budget. If more and more people will migrate from villages to the cities, so the in order to provide the 68% of the world population which will be migrating to cities in 2050, this is a daunting task. This is a challenging task. Municipalities face the challenge of creating a secure environment for its current and future inhabitants. The role of the municipalities is to provide the street lights, comfort to the citizens of the city, and by 2050, providing the street light to all the population living in the city will be a challenging task while being energy and cost efficient. The another challenge is how the energy bill of the municipalities can be reduced and how efficiently these lights can be maintained so that it will be cost efficient. Now, if you see the world electricity consumption in 2018, 19% of the worldwide lighting electricity consumption is there. Rest 81% is the other electricity consumption. And out of this 19% of the worldwide lighting consumption, the street light consume about 3.23%. The residences consume 4.75% of the total lighting consumption. Commercial lighting is the maximum. They consume 9.50% because the commercial shops are illuminated for advertisements and for products illumination. And then industrial lighting is 1.52%. So out of the total 19% of the worldwide global lighting consumption, street lighting consumption is around 3.23% of that. Now, level of interaction for street light solution. So what is the solutions? How we can reduce the power which will be consumed by these street lights? So the first point is information is paramount for any city nowadays. As I told you yesterday about the smart cities, by proper information, by IT and communication technology, by collecting the data, you can make system more efficient, more reliable. Arguably, even more important than direct energy savings. Okay. So this information is very important. Whether it is information regarding the street light functionality, electrical parameters, what is the voltage available on the lighting lamps which is installed on the lighting poles, what is the illumination level, the lux level which the lightings provide, or the city itself, pollution sensors, for example. Like the same street light poles can be used to sense the pollution in the city. All city managers prefer to rely on solid data to optimize city process and operations. So the city managers who are responsible for managing the infrastructure of the city, they need solid data. Solid data in terms of the pollution, in terms of the temperature, in terms of the humidity, in terms of the lux level which is provided by the street lights. Okay, so how many lights are working, functional, non-functional, how many have become old, the illumination is not good. So all these data are required by the city managers or city administrators who are responsible to provide these infrastructure and facilities to their citizens. Operation links to street lighting functionality and maintenance. So what are the links which will visualize whether the street light is functioning properly or not, or it is switched off, and when it requires the maintenance? Functions such as on-off dimming, say early in the morning when the sun rises, the role of street light finishes, the sun gives the proper illumination, at that time the lighting has to be switched off. In the evening hours when the sun sets, are there the illumination level provided by the sun reduces, you have to switch on. And the dimming. Dimming is the feature in the street light. I will explain you how it will work. It will reduce the illumination by reducing the voltage or current into the lamps. So when the power going to the lamp will reduce, its intensity of the light which is emitted by the lighting will be reduced. So there are many ways, say in the night hours after 11 o'clock when the traffic is very low, you don't need such a huge illumination as required from 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. You can dim your lights, or you can dim your lights on alternate poles. So these are the functions. On, off and dimming are the basics of any connected lighting system. Autonomous operation means you should have the photovoltaic cells, the photocells, which will operate when the proper illumination will arrive from the sun. They will switch off the lights. And when the illumination provided by the sun is reduces, they will switch on the lights. So that is called the autonomous operation. It can be time based. There are lightning timers which are operated by the electricity, and they are fixed. Say every day in the 6:30 a.m. the lighting will switch off. Every day in the 6:30 p.m. the lighting will switch on. So it is working as the on and off is on time based. They are not based on the illumination level, whereas the photocell is based on the illumination level. So in the lighting timer control based on the season, or when the day hours are changing continuously, you have to keep on changing the timer on which the light will switch on and switch off. So naturally, you need a man after every 15 days to adjust the time so that the optimum power consumption will be there. Whereas in the case of photocells, no such time adjustment is required. Then there is adaptive lighting. The meaning of adaptive lighting is if the traffic on the road on the pedestrian is zero, no person is moving, no car is driving on the road, so there are motion sensors. Whenever the car will arrive or the people will be moving onto the pedestrian, the motion signal will illuminate the light. And as soon as he passes the area of control of the lighting pole, the lighting will be switched off. So that is called the adaptive lighting. The whole purpose is that you illuminate the road or pedestrian only when the people are there. When the people are not there, it should not be there. So by adoption of adaptive lighting system in the street light, you can control the energy consumption drastically. And maintenance optimization can further support the cause of smart street lighting. Maintenance optimization means whenever the light is off, immediately it has to be attended. No street light should remain out for weeks together or months together. On daily basis, a light monitoring system has to be there, which will automatically generate a notification or SMS to the utility people who are responsible for maintenance of the street lighting. So it's everything is automatic. No human intervention is required. No complaint logger is required. No person is required to hand over this non-available slip to utility people to attend the smart street lighting. Now, optimization is based on the information, but it needs not to be confused with it. It is entirely different process on the information, and ignoring its benefit may render any amount of valuable information useless. So based on the information, you can generate your system of operation and maintenance. It is a continuous pursuit that can be grounded on a city-wide infrastructure like intelligence lighting system. Intelligence lighting system is, it will switch on automatically based on the illumination of the sun. It will reduce its illumination based on the requirement, whether the people are there on the street lights or not, on the roads or not. So it is called the intelligence lighting. Provide the lighting only when it is required. Now, level of interaction for street light solutions. The integration lead to synergy. Smart lighting, smart traffic. On the same street light poles, you can put the traffic lights. You can, on the same street lights, you can have the sensors for smart waste disposal, and smart utilities are all good. Together they are even better. So if you synergize lighting system, street lighting system, traffic system, waste disposal system, synergize, use the same IT infrastructure to monitor, to control them, then it is called the synergy. So many companies focus on their area of expertise, but cities aim to improve the entire system. So as a municipality or as a city administration, they are not only concerned about the better street lighting system, they are concerned about the entire things, the cleanliness of the city, the water distribution, the education system, the health system. So all these to be synergized. Recent studies credit smart system that are open to integration to lead the smart city revolution. So the infrastructure which is used to provide the street light, same infrastructure along with the power distribution, along with this IT cables or fiber optic cable, can be used for watching the pollution level, for the ambient temperature, for the humidity, for the city traffic, for the parking of car. The same infrastructure or the same street light poles can be used for charging your battery car, electric vehicles. Street lighting technology and system advanced faster now than ever before. So in the last, say, 10 to 15 years, there is a drastic change in the technology. So earlier it was the tungsten filler lamps or mercury vapor lamps or sodium vapor lamps or helium lamp. They all consume too much of energy to give the same illumination. So this technology is very changing fast and need to always bring more to the table to the benefit of the people, municipalities and planet. So slowly, slowly we are transforming these high intensity density lights, that is the sodium vapor lamp and mercury vapor lamp, to LEDs. In the process of modernizing the public lighting system, municipalities can opt for diverse street lighting control system, street lighting remote control software solutions, or communication technology to build connected street lighting infrastructure. Because the information technology and this data analytics or the computer software, they are developing in a very enormous rate for last 10 years. So the IT technology can be used to make your street light smart. Okay. So today's smart street lighting is a combination of distribution power system and this IT system. These all bring benefits within and outside the scope of the public lighting. So this is how, this is the street lights. These are the various types of software like Sigfox, the LoRaWAN, and this NB-IoT, the LTE, GSO. So all these softwares are there. And they are connected to the central command control stations. And these street light poles can be used to monitor the CO2 level. They can be used for parking purpose. They can be used for electrical vehicle charging. They can be used for traffic management system. So same street light poles, which is connected with IT technology or fiber optic cable and the electrical power system, can be used for all those applications. Now, earlier, what is happening, say 30, 40 years back, a lineman or the electrician was deputed. He will move around the city and switch off all the lights. So if he starts switching off, say by 6 a.m., it will take around 2 hours. So some lights will keep on illuminating till 8 hours. So after that, the era has changed and the photocell and the timer control, lighting timer control, come into picture. Okay, so now the system in the lighting control or photovoltaic system, the power is not available to street light poles. So they serve only one purpose. That only one purpose is to illuminate the street lights in the daytime when the power is not available to the street light poles. We cannot use for car charging, we cannot use for traffic control, we cannot use for parking system, we cannot use to detect the CO2 level present into the atmosphere. Okay, so all this is there. Or we cannot use these lighting poles to monitor the humidity into the city. So these are the lighting poles and they are the areas, and there is one distribution panel. This distribution panel is different from the normal panel. In the normal panel, what is there? By switching on and off, all the entire lights can be switched off. When you switch it off, then all the poles will be without electricity. And when all the poles will be without electricity, we cannot use them for other purpose, for electrical vehicle charging. The coming era of, say, after 5 years, you won't find any IC engine car. All electrical vehicles will be there. So at that time, these electrical poles in a smart city and a smart city lighting system can be used to charge the vehicle. So these are the control panels. So these are the lighting fixtures provided with the halogen lamps or the sodium vapor lamps. And these are the lighting poles on the arms of that. These poles are, these street light fixtures are mounted. The main elements of a street lighting systems are the lamps, which give the illumination. A street lamp is made from a lamp socket, which mechanically support the electrical connections and allows the lamp to be conveniently replaced. So the lamp socket will hold the lamps, and there will be electrical connections to the lamp socket to give the energy to the lamp. And when the lamp is out fused, then you can replace it. Without replacing the socket, you can replace the lamp. The igniter in the traditional sodium vapor lights or the mercury sodium vapor lamps, igniter provides the high striking voltage because these lamps container contains the gas, sodium gas. So you need to convert the sodium into the vapor form, you need a high striking voltage. So you need an igniter. Igniter serves the purpose of providing the high voltage to ignite a street lamps. There are ballasts which will reduce the voltage and regulate the electric current. So they are the current limiting device in a power system, in a street lighting system. And the capacitor is used to stabilize the voltage and power flow, because these are the inductive circuit. They will bring down the power factor of the distribution system. So in all the street light lamps, we provide the capacitor to improve the power factor. Compared to the traditional lamps, smart street lamps have the capability to be remotely powered on and off and dimmed by means of the controllers. So if we have the smart street lamps, they can be switched on from remote, switched off from remote, and their illumination level can be reduced. Okay, so there are controllers which will be doing it. We will be learning about them. These can be integrated inside the lamp from the production stage or mounted on the lamps. Nowadays, the LED lamps are there, which have got the built-in session, motion system, or they have the controllers, which is built inside the lamp also. So when you are producing, when you are purchasing the street lamps or street lighting, then always prefer a lamp which is a smart lamp, which is at the production stage, it has got the built-in controller inside it. Then there are high intensity discharge lamps versus LED lights. What is better, LED light is better or high intensity discharge lamps are there? We will discuss both. The main purpose of intelligent street lighting is to better light up the roads, pavements and parking spaces to guarantee the citizens' security. So this is the main purpose of intelligent street lighting system. Now, to ensure visual safety to drivers and pedestrians, smart lighting needs to meet the specific value of the luminance. Okay, luminance or dimness, uniformity and the glare according to the road type. Whether it is a wider road or narrow road, in the narrow road you need lesser illumination, in the wider road, say 5-lane or 6-lane, you need the better illumination level. Okay, HID and LEDs are currently most popular lights used to grant high quality efficient lighting. HID lamps are still commonly used around the world for lighting of vast areas, even though they have lower implementation cost and are less costlier as compared to LED lights to replace than the LED lights, HIDs are increasingly being replaced by the LEDs. There are many good features of the LED lights vis-a-vis the HID lamps. That's why the LED lamps are used. Kerala is one state in our India which have used 100% street light based on the LED technology. HID lights have warm-up period of 20 seconds. Yes. Another drawback of HID lamps or the sodium vapor lamps or mercury vapor lamp is that when you switch on the supply, it will take 20 seconds to give full illumination. That is the warm-up time. The time when the mercury and sodium will get converted into vapor and they will start diffusing light. So that is the 20 seconds time until reaching full power. Can emit up to 70% less visible light after only 10,000 hours being in use. So when the lamp becomes 10,000 hours, running hours of the lamp, then its illumination will reduce to 70%. And about 30% of the energy produced is infrared, which is entirely wasted energy. So if you see, if you try to touch the sodium vapor lamps and the illumination condition, its temperature is about 190 degrees centigrade. The glass temperature of the sodium mercury and mercury vapor lamp is 190 degrees centigrade. Such a high temperature glass will emit heat energy into atmosphere, and the infrared or the heat energy is not visible. So it will not increase any illumination level on the road or the pavement. LEDs, on the other hand, have an extremely long lifespan. New LEDs last for about 100,000 hours. It is 10 times, the life of LED lamp is 10 times more than this sodium vapor lamps. Reduce energy cost up to 60%. So the energy bill of the municipality will reduce by 60%. That is a big, big advantage. So once you convert all the HID lamps by the LED lamps, your extra bill will be reduced to 60%. Even you might note in your house that earlier the expenditure which we carried out on this normal type of tube lights and the tungsten filament lamp has reduced drastically by replacing them by the LED lamps. Yeah. So there is no warm-up period. Immediately you switch on, the LED will start giving you the illumination. So they have time and pay for themselves for 6 to 18 months. So if you replace the HID lamp with the LED lamp, depending upon the power, the cost difference between the LED lamps and the HID lamp will be paid back in 6 to 18 months time. Okay, for 9, 10 years, then you can use it freely. Then comes the lighting poles. For centuries, lighting poles have been used to place street lighting sources and have evolved together with the lighting technology. So earlier we were using 6 meter, 9 meters, 10 meters pole to illuminate the lights, and the height of the pole will depend on the width of the road. Wider road, higher will be the pole. Later they were used to support traffic lights or communication infrastructure. Same street light poles in the smart cities use the traffic lights and for communication infrastructure. Okay, communication infrastructure means because the energy is available 24 hours on these lighting poles, your signal, whether it is the RF signal or fiber optic cable signal, can be received by these. But the recent technology development promised to bring it to the pole position of smart city initiatives. Okay, so this technology, IT technology, is brought to the street light poles for various purposes, electrical vehicle charging, parking, humidity scanning, the ambient temperature scanning, the pollution scanning. Same street light poles can be used for multi-purpose. It has got the power round the clock. Lighting poles have two characteristics that make them essential to smart city development. they are widespread and they are powered. So you need not to worry about the infrastructure for IT technology. They are powered round the clock and they are spread throughout the city. So these can be used to collect the data and transmit the data to the central control room. Especially with the smart lamp level control, the street lighting grids are continuously under power. Even during the day, a problem with legacy street lighting. So in the traditional lighting, the day hours, the power is not there. But with the help of smart street light, if even in the daytime when the dark clouds are there, the illumination received from the solar energy reduces, you can switch on the street light in the daytime also. Therefore, there are many sensors and IoT Internet of Things devices that can be mounted on and supplied from street lighting poles using any available communication and laying the grounds for smart city synergies. So instead of performing only one role, the street light pole can be used for many other purposes, which will be because you need not to have the sensors installed on separate poles. Same lighting poles can be used to install the sensors to communicate the data to central control room. Now comes the power cabinet, which is the distributing point for the street light system. The traditional method for switching a cluster of street lights is via a device in control cabinet triggered on a timer or a photocell. So earlier, what is happening? The lighting control panel will have the timers really in the 6 a.m. light will be off, really in the 6 p.m. on the evening the light will be on. Or if you don't want to adjust the time because in the summer the days are longer, the nights are shorter. In the winters the nights are longer and the days are shorter. So you need not to, if you want to skip of that responsibility, if the continuously change the time in the timer, you can use the photocells. The photocells is an automatic device which will sense the solar illumination, and when the solar illumination is less, the lighting will be switched on automatically. So it is the control, the time control is not required in the photocell, whereas in the lighting timer control, you have to control the time throughout the year. When modernizing existing street lighting infrastructure, control cabinets are an essential element. So this control cabinet is an essential element. They must be able to support energy saving technologies such as LED lights and smart lighting management system, which is based on the IT technology. For example, modern control cabinets should be able to pass the light switching impulses from a modern lighting control center on to the individual lighting devices on the street light poles and link the street lighting system to smart sensors, actuators when necessary. So what these lighting control cabinet will do, they will receive the signal from the central command station and they will pass on these impulses, such as impulses, which will switch on the light from control cabinet to the individual lights. So it is like this. So this is the lighting control panel. It is grid monitoring, and these are these lighting poles. Okay. Now this is the central commanding station, which is having full of the communication infrastructure, and then there is a central microprocessor is there, in which you can see many street lights of a city area wise. It is driven by the software. And through this central command control station, you can give the command to lighting poles. Suppose this light, you want to dim it, means say 11 p.m. in the night when the traffic is not there, you can control the illumination level of this light. Say in the 7 p.m., 8 p.m., it is fully bright. Full illumination is there. In the night hours, when the traffic is less, you can reduce the illumination level. So sitting in the central command station, you can control the light which is emitted by these lighting poles. And similarly, suppose this street light pole is out, its LED has damaged, or there is some cable fault. So it will give the real-time alert via this communication infrastructure to central command station. So what you can do, sitting in a control room, you can know that which light is off. And this is an automatic software. It will generate a notification to the lighting maintenance crew team that this lighting pole number is out. You have to rectify. So as and when this goes out, there will be information, there will be a notification or message to the maintenance crew team to repair this light. So that is the real-time alert. Okay, then this is the real-time control. In the morning hours, you can switch off the light, but the energy will be available here. In the evening hours, you can switch on. So this is the real-time control. Then based on this schedule, that suppose in the night hours, you don't want to illuminate this because the illumination of this and this lighting pole is sufficient to illuminate the light. So you can make a schedule that this light will remain on for 8 p.m. to 11 p.m. and then after switch off. So many functions can be achieved with the amalgamation of distribution system, street lighting system, and the software and the communication technology. So you can control the illumination level, you can switch off based on this timing, smart schedule, and you can switch on and switch off. So all these functions are there. So similarly, there are these are this this mounted with the sensors. This will emit the communication with respect to what is the voltage level over here, what is the current it is drawing, what is the illuminance level it is spreading onto the road. So such type of data about the street light will be communicated over here. So by selecting a lighting pole, you will have the entire information, the voltage of the street light, the current of the street light, how much illumination it is illuminating. You can use it for, say, dust pollution control. You can have the pollution control. You have all the things. So this is smart street lighting not only control the illumination level, it saves a lot of energy. Now, street lighting control. The idea of street lighting control appears long ago from the struggle of managing large number of lamps. So earlier, say 1970s, 1960s, the municipalities deploy the people to switch on and switch off light daily in the evening and daily in the morning. A solution was needed so that the lamp could be clustered in a small numbers and handled more efficiently in terms of powering on and off and power outage and maintenance, etc. So instead of providing, say, 1,000 lights on one circuit, what you can do, you can provide 200 lights on one circuit. Okay, so that the maintenance will be easy and the power outage will not be there due to electrical faults. Okay. Thus, lighting panel control and monitoring units were invented and used to restructure the public lighting system. So earlier, those lighting distribution panel has got only one MCB. You switch it off, the light will be off. You switch it on, the light will be on. Later on, the photo cells were installed and the lighting timers were installed. And nowadays, the sensors and modems are installed to receive the command from the central control and pass on these commands to lighting lamps. This allowed for each light segment to be manually powered on. Later controllers were installed on these lighting control units. They took the place of human intervention. Earlier, it is all human control. The switch on and switch off and maintenance was human control, functioning as an automation for switching the light on and off. So smart street light means you don't require, everything should be automatic. You don't require human beings to control it. Since then, street lighting needed to become more effective, less energy consuming, and less polluting. Because when you consume lesser energy, the pollution caused by the CO2 into the power station will be reduced. So the control system have evolved to become smart by allowing the lamp control and data collection. So same street light poles is used to control the illumination level and data collection. How that lamp is working, that data is collected, whether it is working or not working. This was made possible by allowing segment level and lamp level control via cabinet or luminaire controller respectively. So you can have at the street lamp, you can have the controller, or you can have the controller in the distribution panel. A smart street lighting system controlled at segment level comprises a cluster of 200 street lamps that communicate to a power cabinet. So the 200 lamps will be communicating with the power cabinet, which allows automatic on and off control. So these panels will be automatic, giving the command to these photovoltaic signals to automatically on and off. The feeder pillars receive data from the lamps, manages and transmits the relevant data to a secure server, which stores and displays it onto the dashboard, as I have shown over here. So every information, every data, functioning or non-functioning, on-off, dimmer control is controlled from the central control room server. Individual lamp control is handled via a luminaire controller. So if you want to control an individual lamp, suppose, as I told you, say out of three poles, you want the illumination only on two poles. The middle pole should not be illuminated after 11 p.m. So if such a precise control of lighting is required, then you have to have a luminaire controller, which will control the individual lights, which have lamp level functionality and intelligence and allow for on-off dimming control of adaptive lighting. So all the functions of switch on, switch off, the illumination controller by dimming control, or the adaptive lighting, whether some passengers is on the pavement or the car is flying onto the road, that is called the adaptive lighting. So when there is nobody, no lighting is required. That is the concept. So why to waste energy when on the empty roads or the empty pavement or the empty parks? That is the whole concept about the intelligence lighting. Luminaire controller can also provide electrical parameters, feedback for every lamp. As I told you, the voltage, current, power factor, everything can be given. The LED lights have got the unity power factor. They don't consume any reactive power. That is the beauty of the LED lights. Real-time malfunction reporting on, say, a real-time basis, when some LED lamps goes out, some cable fault is there or some fuse has blown, it will be reported. And optional sensor to measure light, what is the illumination level, the motion on the pavement and the road that the people are walking or the car is flying, the temperature and humidity and noise. So all these parameters you can scan by the help of street light poles. Okay? So it will not only provide the illumination, it will sense the motion, it will measure the light, what is the illumination which is provided by this lighting, it will sense the temperature, ambient temperature, what is the ambient humidity, and what is the noise, pollution. And similarly, if the dust particles are there, there is the scanner which will sense the dust particle, and it will sense you the particulate level. Like in Delhi, you have to provide a separate system for pollution sensing. But the same street light poles in the smart cities can be used for dust control. In addition, lamp level control keeps the lighting grid powered up during the daytime. It will be switched on round the clock, which allows the installation of other smart city appliances like sensors for humidity, temperature, pollution, the controllers which will control the traffic lights, the car car charging, the CCTV cameras for the security and safety of the people, or communication devices. So smart street lighting means it will not give you only one function for illumination of the roads and the pavement. It will do many, many other functions. So this is all technical. If you like, I can describe. It is like this. Say how to control the voltage level of lamp. Say this is the DC voltage, which is converted from 220 volt AC into DC in a lighting fixture. And then this is the inverter. So if the switch is off, then the voltage will be zero. Nowadays, with the advent of the power electronics, with the IGBT and this silicon oxide metal oxide transistors like MOSFET, metal oxide silicon field effect transistors, these switches can function very fast. In one cycle, that is of 20 milliseconds, it can on and off 10,000 times. So earlier, the analog switches were not capable of switching on so many times. But with the advent of the power electronics like the IGBT and this MOSFET, the switching action has become very fast. So what you can do, when it connects to positive, the voltage will go up and remain there till it is connected. When it is switched off, it will return back. When it is connected to negative, it will go to negative. And for how long it is remained connected, this voltage will appear, and then it comes in between. So the DC voltage will be converted into AC, square waves. These are the MOSFET, which I told you that they can operate 10,000 times in a cycle period. Okay. So what is happening? This gate of this MOSFET is insulated by the silicon dioxide. And this is the source and this is the drain. So this is working as a switch. Now, if you apply a positive voltage over here, what will happen? All the positive holes present into the semiconductor will be pushed out. So this area, conducting area, will be rich in the electrons, and the electrons will flow from source to drain. So when you apply the positive voltage, it will conduct. When you remove the positive voltage, it will stop. So that is the function of MOSFET. Then the waveform which we get like this, it is such a waveform is not acceptable. It is not sinusoidal wave, and it contains the harmonics, multiple of the fundamentals. So the solution is to convert this into pulse width modulation. So pulse width modulation in half cycle, it will make on and off many times. So such type of cycles will be triggered. Similarly, in the negative half cycle, it will trigger like this. So with the help of this type of technology, we can control the frequency of AC power from this device, and we can control the magnitude of the AC voltage. So say these are the conduction angle and these are the non-conduction angle. If you sum up this, then we'll get this type of sinusoidal wave. So there are many duty cycle, 50% on, 50% off, 75% on, 25% off, and 25% on, and 75% off. So these are available in various duties. This is what I was telling you, that the current going to the lamp is dependent upon the voltage we apply. If we apply the voltage to the gate, MOSFET gate, then the collector current will increase. And the current will increase, the illumination level will increase. That is how this illumination is controlled. So that is the actual circuit. Okay. Say this is the MOSFET and this is the lamp. This is the positive bus and this is the zero voltage. So we can control the voltage applied across the lamp. So if we apply this trigger pulse obtained from the central command station, this will come positively charged and the source will communicate with the drain and this lamp will illuminate. The moment is it stopped, it will become zero. But the frequency by which it will be, this can trigger 10,000 times in a cycle. So you will not see that the illumination is broken. In a cycle, it will switch on and switch off 10,000 times. So we can control by the frequency of these square waves, which is applied to this MOSFET, the illumination level of the lamp. So that is how the dimmer control is made into this smart street light system. The illumination level of this lamp can be controlled by these pulses which you receive from the central command control room. Now, then there are different, like if you have got the HID, the sodium vapor lamps, then the new pack power electronics is there. It is different from this, you can say the thyristors. Thyristor conduct only from positive to negative anode to cathode, but these track device conduct in both cycle. The gate pulse, when you apply, then the positive it will conduct, and if you apply it to the gate of this, reverse will be there. So this is the symbol of the track, and thus the AC power which is going to the lamp for sodium vapor lamp can be controlled like this. So by controlling this T1 into timer, you can control how power is going to the lamp, and by controlling the power going to the lamp, you can control the illumination of the lamp. And there are AC to DC converter which will convert AC into DC, and then there are DC to DC converter. These are very high speed operating switches, so we can control the DC to DC voltage. Okay, suppose the LED is supplied by 18 volts. Mostly these LEDs are supplied by 220 volt AC, and then there is a card, electronic card in the LED lamp, which will convert this 220 volt AC to 12 volt DC or 18 volt DC, depending upon the architect of the LEDs in the lights. So when this is switched on and off many times, you can control the input DC voltage. So in the LED lights, we use a DC-DC converter to control the dimmer level or illumination level of the lamp. Okay. Now, there are standards. The main standard for lamp control are 0 to 10, DALI 1, DALI 2, digital addressable lighting interference. So these are the standards for lamps. The important thing is to make sure that the smart lighting controllers are compatible to the lamp control system. As I told you, different controller, AC to AC voltage controller, AC to DC, DC to DC. So those controllers will be compatible with the lamps, whether it is a HID lamp or LED lamp. Furthermore, some lighting controllers allow for further connectivity. Sensor for special functions can be added to the system, whether for deploying special lighting control characteristics or to mount additional or non-related sensors. Non-related sensors mean you can install the motion sensor, you can install the temperature sensor, you can install the humidity sensor, you can install the pollution sensors, okay? Or you can install the video cameras. The adaptive lighting is such an example. I already explained you. When there is nobody present, the lighting will be off. When it is somebody is not present, then it will be on. This require, besides controller's technical ability, adding a motion sensor to the lighting pole, usually connected directly to the lighting controller. So there are motion sensors. When there is no motion, the light will be off. As soon as some car approaches the street light poles or some people approach the pavement, then it will sense the motion sound signal and it will switch on the lights. So these are called the motion sensors. The street lighting controller types and form factor and mounting options. The lighting controller is the base for every smart street lighting installation. Depending upon the type of installation, the controller can be connected to the lamp or to the power cabinet. You can have this controller inside the distribution panel or inside the lamp. When installed in the power cabinet, things are quite straightforward, as aesthetic is not an issue. You need not to change any modification to the street lights. All the controllers will be installed into the street lighting cabinet. And there is usually power and communication available, so there is not much a debate left. So in the distribution panel, the power will be available round the clock, always available. So when you install the IoT things or the communication channel or this Wi-Fi, then the power is available round the clock. However, when approaching lamp level street light controller, the things may be getting a bit complicated. There are three type of restrictions that you should keep in mind. How to design the lamp controller, how to install it, and communication. Often, street lamps fulfill more than a functional role. They have become a key asset in creating and maintaining the local architecture value. Whether modern, classic, or retro, street lighting fixtures need to complement the local architect, and smart lighting controller need not to ruin that effort. So the beauty of the street light foil should not be damaged. Like you hang a controller outside the street light poles, it looks very ugly to the pedestals and the people who are wandering on that road. So the beauty of the lighting pole should not be damaged when you are installing a controller onto the lighting poles. It is unlikely that a city architect would accept a modern piece of electronics to be visible on their black rod box. So they don't like it that the wrought iron poles should have the modern controller which is hanging outside the poles. It should be inside the pole. Furthermore, as any change in the street lighting grid involves cumbersome civil work, it is important for city managers to keep installation cost at a minimum. So better to install into the panels, or you purchase the lamps which has got the controller inside there. That is why lighting engineers have invested in several mounting solutions to ensure a smooth lamp upgrade and fast lighting controller installation. Okay. On lamp socket installation, it is by far the fastest way to get smarter street lights. So you purchase the smart lamps which has got the controller inside it, motion sensor and all that, and which can communicate through Wi-Fi to the central commanding station. Most lamps today come in the NEMA or Jhaga socket options. The NEMA socket is a street lighting connector derived from the American socket standard that was expanded worldwide. So these sockets contain the controller. Jhaga is a newer, more compact connector that aims to take over the street developed especially for today's slim LED fixtures. So you can replace the socket, ordinary socket, with a Jhaga socket or NEMA socket, which will have the controller built inside. Embedded controller, compact controller to be installed inside the lamps. Oh, so when you purchase that lamp, you have to give the specification to manufacturer that I need a lamp which has got the controller mounted inside the lamp. Then pole mounted controllers mounted inside the lighting pole, it is the most flexible option. Even if it is more complicated to install, needs custom mounting and direct wire connection, more expensive to install it. It should be IP66 so that no dust, dirt and moisture should enter to it. It is the most flexible option available as it does not require any special connection or certain type of lamp stripe. So you can have this. It connects directly so it can be used to retrofit existing street lighting installation with minimal visual impact and virtually no civil work. So whatever technology you use, the beauty architect of the street light poles should not become ugly as installation of that lamp. It should not be visible from outside. It should be mounted inside the poles, or it should be mounted inside the lamp, or it should be mounted inside the panel. The outside visibility of this controller should not be there. Now, we can, what is the time now? we can have the power line communication.
Sir,
we can have a
sir in another 10 minutes you can conclude, sir.
Okay,
thank you, sir.
So just a minute, what is so these are the various technologies used, say for in the same power line, if the communication channel is also flowing, then their range is 50 meters. You can use the RF mesh technology for communication, then their range will extend to 100 meters. Long range RF, you can reach the 3 to 5 kilometers. Or if you use the cellular network, then it is unlimited. You can use up to any length. So these are the different communication technologies, especially connecting the central command control room to individual lamp or individual distribution panel. So you can use the technology depending upon the architect of your power station. These are the converters, sensors, which is used for different purposes, for humidity, for temperature, for noise, for this pollution. So we can conclude urbanization is an issue that all cities need to deal with around the globe. The smart city industry is a 600 billion market with 600 cities around the globe expected to generate 60% of the world GDP by 2025. With over 60% of the world population expected to live in by 2050, it is crucial that these cities are safe, suitable environments for their citizens. It is the end goal for smart cities to improve the quality of the lives of the citizen. The future is smart. And one thing I want to share, a thing is going on, we are far, far lagging. It's like this. The China is in the process of manufacturing artificial moons. So they are housed at 500 kilometers altitude. So at 500 kilometers altitude, it is a satellite mounted moon. And it will receive the solar radiation round the clock because the shadow of the earth will not be on this. So such type of four moons are installed to illuminate a China city. This is 50 kilometer by 50 kilometer. Okay, so it is a one-time expenditure, and it will receive, you will receive the power, you will receive the illumination without any energy consumption. So there the street light power consumption will become zero. So this is the future of street light. We are thinking of information technology, the communication technology, the electronics. But this is the best way to illuminate your cities. No maintenance is required. No central command control is required. No timer is required. All the time it will illuminate. And the illumination level provided by this artificial moon is 8 times than the full moon. The full moon, what illumination gives to the earth, it will emit 8 times the lighting control. And the best advantage is, you can install the solar photovoltaic system to convert this light energy into electricity. So the solar photovoltaic system has got the limitation of say day hours power production. In the night, they don't produce any power. So if you install solar photovoltaic panels in such a location of 50 kilometer by 50 kilometer, you will be able to generate power round the clock, round the year, round the week, throughout the day. So you can go through it. In these slides, I have described you where it is there. So with this, I will conclude.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Sir, few questions are there. A couple of questions, we'll take it up.
Hello. Just hold. Hello. Haan ji. Boliye na. नहीं नहीं अब मत बोलिए. हाँ जी बोलिए. Are the questions mentioned in the chat box?
Yes, sir. Last question. Yeah. Down is the right side chat box. Right side corner, down. Right side corner, sir. Extreme right you go, sir. There. Yes.
Yeah.
Scroll it down, sir. Your session will start that one.
Okay, sir. Scroll. Kindly share the
scroll
timing
it
for
down,
the village.
Sir.
Okay.
Yeah, here.
From here. Okay, sir. Kindly share the timing. Where it is?
No, next. This one, sir. From here.
Sir, you have touched very important topic to save the huge energy, especially in India, which is facing energy shortage. The energy shortage is not there. We have got the surplus generation. Mr. Atal, okay? We are not energy shortage. The generators are surplus. The generators are forced to keep shut down.
This is from Hanumant Rao.
Hanumant Rao. We are at present, we have got 375 gigawatt of the generators. And entire generators are not allowed to generate power. They are under generating. Our government metro should think about it, not limited to smart cities, but sides of the roads, as it will reduce the many worse accidents. Okay. Thank you for the information session, sir. As smart city concept is making use of more of renewable energy sources. Apart from the solar state light, do we have any plans for biomass lamps, algal lamps, and what is the lifespan of solar panel? The lifespan of solar panel is 25 years. They will last for 25 years, the photovoltaic technology seller. Based on the monocrystalline technology, their life is 25 years. Sir, please tell once again about artificial moon. Do you require it?
No, you can share the content, sir, link. We will share it, they will read it.
Okay. How is state light managed for illumination? The street lights are managed for illumination by knowing the traffic. If the traffic is high, the full illumination here. If the traffic is very thin or few people are making rounds, say in 1 hour, then the illumination will be reduced. How street light manages the illumination? There are sensors which will measure the illuminance level, and that information will be given to the central command station to take the control actions. Please tell me in Hindi, sir.
Okay, sir. So those are the questions, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, sir. Okay. Thank you very much. I think you are covered starting from your basic lamps to LED lights, smart pole, smart street light, that is smart street lighting software, then street lighting control, then overall, that is lamp control standards. So overall thing, you have done a wonderful presentation covering entire parameters under smart street lighting management. So thank you for your wonderful and information and presentation, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
So request all
should I leave?
Yes, sir.
Okay.